Okay, this is Donovan Smith, the math coach in the Post Meridium. I post on LinkedIn every day to make sure that I stay engaged and kind of help, my connections kind of reaching out to kind of share some of my gifts that I have within my ministry of just helping people enjoy math. I just want to say a special shout out to all teachers who have to enter back in the classroom, to those teachers who are doing virtual learning. I understand that there are no playbook to this. This is the first time around. I just want to say thank you and continue, sharpening and investing in tomorrow's future. Let's kind of get into this problem right here. This problem is a algebra 2 problem. It requires you to kind of remember a few things. Now, if you did not remember the standard formula of a circle, which is just, and it has to be two perfect binomials right here. And what you have here is just y. This is h. I just want to make sure it's clear. And this is y minus k right here. Square equals r square. And your center is just, what we have to do is substitute the value in for h and k, and just kind of take a look. Like this h right here is positive, this is positive, and it's up here is negative and negative. So just kind of play a little attention to what's going on right here. So now, once you have established this formula, right, some teachers give you the formula and some expect you to kind of commit it to memory. Now, if you take a look at this problem right here, we have two perfect binomials, but some of you will probably look at x right here and don't realize that x is just another way of saying x plus or minus 0, or x plus 0 square, and it's just equal to x squared. So you do have a perfect binomial right here. So now if you take a look at this problem right now, and let me just rewrite it right here, you have x plus, either plus or minus, because 0 is neither, and we're going to say y, which is just negative 3. I'm just rewriting the problem right here, so we could kind of take a look at what we have. I'm going to put a red line right here, just so you guys can know that I'm just rewriting the problem right here. Now, this is the formula in which you guys have to remember. So now, if you take a look at this right here, we could say that for your center right now, we could say for your center is just, it's equal that your h right here is 0. And so we put 0 here. And if we take a look at our k right here, we have a negative right here, and we have a negative here. So a negative times a negative is positive. So this is a positive 3. And then to find the radius of r, to find what the radius is of this r square, what you have to do is that r is square is just 10 right here. So basically, what you have to do is to take the square root of that. And so therefore your radius right here is 10 and your center right here is just 0, 3. That's the center of the circle. So now to kind of help eliminate some things, we could have just took a look at the radius right here and look at our answer choice. If the radius has to be square root of 10, we could just eliminate these. We could eliminate A, B, and E. And now, based upon we did the equation right here, and we kind of able to substitute it, we know that C is the correct answer. And that's just a quick response of it. I didn't really go too much into teaching of that, but this is kind of like a quick brain teaser. Hey, you had YouTube, old math books. Thank you for logging in. appreciate you guys supporting me and just encouraging me to kind of put out these content every day. Have an outstanding day.